Welcome, I'm Hillary, and I'm here to tell you the mystery of the story of Pentecost. Our story begins way back at the very beginning of the Bible, when everybody in the world spoke the same language. Now, at first, they used this to work together. They started to build a tower, and they built it taller, and they built it even taller, and they built it so tall that they began to think to themselves that they were the best there have ever been. They started to think, oh my goodness, perhaps I'm even better than God. So as they continued to build it, God knew that this spirit of haughtiness, this spirit of being better than other people, would someday lead to their destruction. So he confused their language, and everyone started talking a different language, and it sounded loud and like babble. Babble, babble, babble. As soon as that happened, they could no longer understand one another. And their tower fell, and they were dispersed all over the world, each one not being able to hear somebody else or understand what others were saying. Their languages were confused, and they could no longer understand one another. Thousands of years later, there was a man named Jesus, the Messiah. He was born, he lived among us, he was crucified, and he died. And then he rose again from the grave, and he spent 50 days with his followers, the 12 disciples, in the city and around Jerusalem after his resurrection. They spent a lot of time in an upper room. They were afraid to leave. And at that time, after Jesus' death, there were only 11 disciples. Judas had left the group. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 disciples, along with other followers of Jesus, had to stay away from other people. And at first they were afraid. But then Jesus came to them and told them that they should have peace, that peace is with them. And he told this to all of the disciples who were present. He said this to Peter. He said this to James, son of Zebedee, to Simon the Zealot, Andrew, Peter's brother, John, son of Zebedee, Matthew, the tax collector, James, son of Alphaeus, Thomas, sometimes called the twin, Bartholomew, Jude. And he told it to Philip, all 11 of the disciples. After the 50 days were over, Jesus took the 11 disciples up to a hilltop beyond Jerusalem. And there he began to ascend into heaven, lifted up from the earth. But he told the disciples to have joy because the Holy Spirit was coming to them, to be with them as a comforter and a protector. So they went back to Jerusalem, back to that room, and they were filled with awe. They decided they should have 12 disciples again, so with God's help, they elected Matthias to be alongside them as well, and then they were 12 again. Suddenly, on the day of Pentecost, on a Sunday, they were in that upper room when the Holy Spirit came dramatically, like a like a rushing wind into the room, and tongues of fire appeared over each one of them, resting on them, and something amazing happened. They were filled with the Holy Spirit so much that they were able to speak and preach and tell people of the good news of the love of God in each one of their languages. Now, there were pilgrims from all over the world in Jerusalem, and yet somehow they could all be understood and understand what the disciples were saying in their very own language. What had happened at the Tower of Babel was now reversed. Through the work of the Holy Spirit, we could all understand one another again and all understand the beloved love of God. And that is the great mystery of Pentecost. But the mystery continues even today. Pentecost is called the birthday of the church because we think of it as the way we too have been touched by the Holy Spirit. How we too are given the love of God and the Holy Spirit to go and tell everybody we know, so that everyone can know that they are beloved children of God. What a wonderful mystery. Thank you for joining me today, and stay tuned for more stories.